Hello, my lovelies. Welcome to my channel. Here we are doing the monthly reading for all zodiac signs. This is going to be for Scorpio, Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus. Scorpio, I want to wish you guys the very best for this Hallows Eve. Hope you guys are as excited as I am for the coming holidays, right? This is just the beginning. Hope you guys are staying safe. Let's get into your reading. Spirit guides, ancestors, and archangels, what are the messages for Scorpio, Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus for the month of October 2021? What is it that they need to know or they need to hear at this present time? Scorpio, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus for the month of October 2021. One more shuffle. Scorpio. Okay, here we go. Let's get into your reading, Scorpio. We're starting off with the Five of Pentacles. Five of Pentacles may be feeling a bit, feeling like people are not really receiving your energy. And it's almost like a frustration of communication. So I feel that for some of you guys, this could be Mercury retrograde, feeling like you can't fully express because the moment you do, you're kind of rubbing people the wrong way. So it's almost like they're very defensive to constructive criticism coming from your side. So there is a feeling of almost like not being able to fully express what's on your mind here. However, you do have the Sun card, and the Sun card does represent blessings, but it also indicates, I feel people being intimidated by you for this month of October, Scorpio. I think that's the reason why people are very defensive of the way you express yourself. It could have to do with the fact that when you express yourself in such a way where you're very passionate and very intense about what you're speaking or expressing, there's this energy of inspiring people and those that are around you. It's almost like they're looking to you for guidance. And I feel like outside energies are not okay with that. So there may be a specific individual in your circle that may be a bit intimidated by you in regards to this, in regards to perhaps, you know, the way you express yourself is what I'm hearing. For others of you, this could represent you dealing with a Leo, as we do have the Sun card here, Earth energy, Taurus, Capricorn, Virgo. But what they're telling you here is don't allow other people or people outside of yourself to make you feel uncomfortable in your own skin, Scorpio, for this month of October. I feel that that's going to be very crucial. It's almost like don't lose yourself, don't lose your self-identity to make other people around you comfortable. So again, if there's people that, you know, friends of yours that you've known for many years, all of a sudden telling you, hey, Scorpio, you should tone it down, or you shouldn't express yourself that way, or whatever, and it makes you feel uncomfortable, like your gut is telling you, like, you need to speak up, like it's their self-criticism is coming from like a negative energy, speak up. Don't make it like, don't dim your light to make others around you be more comfortable. Your next card here is the Eight of Wands, passion being ignited, your imagination. This is creativity. For some of you guys, this could be, you know, creativity coming to you on a whim and an idea, something that just comes to you very randomly. What they're telling you is if you feel like you're passionate about it or excited about it, follow that. That's your intuition telling you or guiding you towards a blessing. And this could be something that happens rather spontaneously. So it could be a kind of like an idea that can turn into a career, or that could turn into a hobby, and that hobby turns into something where you're actually making a living off of that. So pay attention to that type of energy as well. Now we also have the Moon card here. Funny, because we have the Sun and the Moon. What does that represent? That represents light, right? The Sun is blessings. It's what we're able to see. The Moon is night. It's intuition. It's mystery. And it's also hidden feelings, hidden, almost like hidden enemies, right? People that you would consider or that you think are portraying themselves to be friends that actually have like a double face, or that they're not having your, you know, your best interest at heart. With the Sun card here and the Eight of Wands, there is almost like this uncertainty surrounding some type of connection. For some of you guys, it could be that you're intuitively picking up on perhaps your partner not being completely honest or completely transparent about something. For others of you, this could be your partner feeling that way about you, especially if you've been acting a bit erratic, Scorpio. So keep that in mind if you are walking a straight path and you notice that your partner is being a little bit more jealous or perhaps doubtful about certain things or feeling like you're not being completely honest, try the best you can to kind of take a step back and analyze the actions you've been taking. I heard erratic, and that usually indicates like the moon having an effect on you. So that could be the reason why you're acting a bit different. But again, those of you guys that are, you know, doing things you shouldn't be doing, be careful with the sun and the eight of wands. Truths are coming out and they're going to come out quick. And this could also represent rumors. It's almost like that one person that catches you doing something and then it catches on like wildflower. So again, wildflower, I said wildfire is what I meant. But what they're telling you here is, again, keep a watchful eye for that. Now, finally here, your card is Queen of Cups. Listen to your intuition, Pisces. You're being guided. Scorpio. For some of you guys, you may be dealing with the Pisces. Here's the thing. What I'm hearing is with the Queen of Cups, listen to your intuition. If you've been ignoring your intuition, almost like you're getting a warning or you're feeling like you're doing things that perhaps you shouldn't be doing, and you're kind of feeling like some weird type of energy, listen to that, because I feel that that's your spirit guides trying to prevent something from unfolding in a negative aspect when we're talking about relationships, okay? I do see you guys being a bit tempted. So again, be careful with that, Scorpio, especially those of you guys that are in a long-term committed relationship or you guys have children. Just be mindful about that, okay, my lovelies? All right, I wish you guys the very best. Hope this gives you some type of insight, and we'll see each other soon. Bye.